Hello everybody, and we are about to continue our Let's Play series of Demon Souls. As you can see, we are back in soul form, and the way you're going to want to do that each time after you go back into body form is to just kill your character while in the Nexus. It does not impact world tendency. Okay, so we're going to continue our adventure, and just for fun, we're going to go to the next Archstone. Archstone of the Digger King. Stonefang Tunnel, the Smithing Grounds, a city of miners who maintained the giant tunnel. Long ago, the efforts of the hard-headed burrowers allowed Boletarian soldiers to carry out their work, but now, dispossessed of their souls, they have no thoughts of their own and work in silence, tirelessly without purpose. Let's get into it. Up ahead is a crystal lizard. You're going to want to always attack these because they have upgrade materials. They will respawn after you kill a boss in the world. This guy is another merchant within the game, and you can pick up items such as upgrade materials such as hearthstone shards and sharpstone shards, as well as healing items and the pickaxe if you want to use that weapon. Looks like we have two miners throwing boulders. You're going to want to wait until you can kind of cross, and you should make it okay. Next, you want to turn the wheel, and that's going to start the contraption. This is our first encounter with a fat official. They like to throw fire at you. Just kind of block it. Okay, now these enemies are the miners. You'll see that you don't do much damage to them with your scimitar because they have hard scales. So we're just going to quick switch to our mailbreaker, which can pierce through their scales. The Crushing Battle Axe is another option you can use throughout your playthrough. sticky white slime is essentially going to apply magic to your weapon. It is a sticky white wax-like substance. It will come in handy when we fight some bosses in this area. And we're going to continue through the mine. Appears to be Backstab City over here at the moment. The miners with the bags tend to have more materials that you can get when you dispatch them. To take out the fat official that's kind of sitting over here, I advise just shooting him with a bow. We got another miner sitting over here. Kind of draw him out a little bit. This item is the pickaxe. If you would still like to use that as your weapon, you can pick it up right there. again, an easy way of taking out the fat official is to just use your bow and arrow. Next, you want to cross the little platform over here. Okay, we're going to work our way back up the path to get to the area we just unlocked. Now you can go this way if you want to collect some materials. I'm personally not going to be using the materials in this playthrough, but if you want to go this way, you're just going to take out each one of those little fire monsters on the wall, and then you have, I believe, some dragonstone upgrade materials, and I think some elixir.
Yeah.
before going through the little fog wall over here, we're going to quick unlock the shortcut that's sitting over on this side. We're going to start up the contraption. And we're going to go all the way down. And if you remember, our blacksmith in the Nexus, Baldwin, mentioned another blacksmith. And we are about to meet right here.
I haven't seen you around these parts. What does it matter? You need a blacksmith? Show me your steel. If not, head straight for the door. I'm busy. I'm not here to chit-chat. Forging a weapon strengthens it and alters its character. Ores are transmogrified spirits. Their presence blesses the weapon.
Okay, we're not going to really be using him at the moment, but later on in the playthrough we will be visiting him again to upgrade certain weapons. And that is going to do it for our current video. I would like to thank all of you for tuning in, and we will talk again real soon.